Hey everyone, welcome to my channel. If you're new here, this is Annie, and in today's video I'm going to talk about my favorite, I can't say my favorite, but the kajals I have right now in my vanity and what my thoughts are about them. So if you're interested, please keep on watching. So I have divided it into like 5 categories. One is the packaging, the pigmentation, the stay, the finish, and how I use it. And so the first kajal I'm going to talk about is the L'Oreal Infallible Gel Crayon 24-Hour Waterproof Kajal. So basically this is a gel kajal which can be used as an eyeliner as well as a kajal. So it comes in a pencil type, so you know, like, you have to keep sharpening it and there will be product wastage. Pigmentation wise, it's really black. I really like the pigmentation and how intense it can be. So this is how black it is. So that's one thing I really like, and stays on for pretty long time. Like, since it's a gel kajal, it stays like for 7 to 8 hours. I think since I have really oily eyelids, it stays only that long for me, but I'm guessing that people who have normal eyelids, it might stay longer, because for me almost all kajals, they smudge after a while. And so I use it only as, like, I don't like, somehow I'm not a fan of the gel finish on my on my eyelid. So I usually use it as a on my lower lash line, like, you know, just below my lower lashes, so to give that finish. And I use it only for occasions, because it gets over pretty soon and it's a gel kajal and you have to sharpen it, so I don't use it on an everyday basis, but I really like it a lot. The next one is the Chamber Intense Definition Gel Eyeliner Pencil. This doesn't give as much of a gel finish than the L'Oreal one, and it comes in a twister, so this is only like a one way, like, you can't, once you twist it up, you can't twist it back down, so you should be really careful the way you use it. And I think they do that because the product dries up if it's twisted up. I'm not too sure, I'm just guessing, maybe that's why you can't twist it back down, you know, so that the product inside stays moistened. Other than that, I really like the pigmentation of this as well. It's pretty much similar to the L'Oreal, but it has a grayer finish to it, like, and it gives a velvet matte finish. So since it's different, I kind of like it for that, and because it's a velvet matte finish, and it stays on, like, not as long as the L'Oreal one. Maybe like it stays for 7 hours on my eyelids. And other than that, I use it as both eyeliner as well as kajal, so I really like it on an everyday basis as well. So the next one is the MAC Technicolor Liner Eyeliner Kajal. This comes in a twist up packaging, so it's really convenient, and the pigmentation is actually very black. This is in the shade Graph Black, so I mean, they all are pretty much the same. So this is the, in pigmentation wise, so this is the MAC one. So but the problem with this one is it smudges very soon on my eyes, but it's also very comfortable on my eyes since I have sensitive eyes. But the only con is, like, it smudges like within like 3 hours or so, so I just use it on the top like an eyeliner. So other than that, I really like this kajal. It's just a normal kajal. Like, I think you can find drugstore alternatives, and you don't have to spend so much on a MAC kajal, especially if you have oily eyelids like me. It's not gonna stay. But other than that, I like it for everyday use, maybe because I feel very comfortable wearing it. The next one is the Lakme Absolute Kohl Ultimate kajal, and this comes in a pencil form. And this is actually one of my favorite among all I'm talking about. So this, pigmentation wise, it is not on par, I feel, because it's not that black, if you can see here. And since it is, it comes with a smudger, so it's meant for, you know, to give that smoky look. So even when you just apply it, it gives a smoky finish. like it's not just a straight line. It just gives, like, if you can see, you know, it gives that smoky effect to it. I really like it. I don't use a smudger, but it's like perfect for my sensitive eyes, and it doesn't smudge as fast as the MAC one as also. So I use it both for my upper and my lower lash line, and the only thing is it's a pencil, so it'll get over really fast, but the quality is top notch with this one. The final one is the Lakme Iconic Kajal. I don't think I have to say much about it. This is very similar to the MAC Kajal, I feel, the effect wise, and I think it stays even longer than the MAC one, and the pigmentation is really it just broke. So the pigmentation is really there with this one. I think it's like it's the blackest of all of them. But the main issue I have with this is my eyes kind of become itchy after like 4 hours of wearing it. I have no idea why, but I really like the price point and the lasting power and the pigmentation. Everything is perfect except that one reason. So I use it only for, like, if I have to wear it to to the supermarket or to somewhere where I just have to spend like 2-3 hours. I just use it for that, but I don't think I'm going to repurchase this one. Since my eyes are very sensitive, I think I should be careful what product I choose. But the same thing, the Lakme Absolute one is like, the quality wise, it's like up there. So yeah, I don't recommend this one. Not all herbal kajals are good for sensitive eyes, because I have tried Lotus, Biotic, I've even tried Plum. But somehow they either cause a burning sensation or an itchy feel, because I guess it has herbal contents, but not all herbal contents will suit everyone. That's what I'm trying to say. And it's also better to get ophthalmologically tested products if you're going to use it on your eyes, and especially if your eyes are sensitive. So that's why I just stick to brands mostly which are which are like ophthalmologically tested, and I don't go for herbal brands because of that. So I just want to put out that. Well, that's about it, guys. Hope you enjoyed the video and hope you found it helpful. So don't forget to like, subscribe and share the video, and I'll see you soon in my next one. Take care. Bye.